Hey, what's up guys? Joe Cadwell here, and today I'm going to show you guys how to make a custom workspace in Adobe Premiere Pro. And it's
Tutorial Tuesday!
Okay guys, so here we are in Premiere Pro, and if you go up to Window, and you go to Workspaces, and you click on Editing, your workspace should come up and it should look something similar to this. It probably will be this. So the cool thing about Premiere is that this entire workspace is customizable. And up here at the top, they give you a list of different presets that come in Premiere. And this one you'll see says Joe C. That's a custom one I made. So it's not all presets, but once you start making some custom ones, they'll show up here too. And so we're in editing right now. And the setup of this one is the project panel down here at the bottom, the source monitor on the left, the program monitor on the right, timeline, tools, and some meters over here, some audio meters. So to get right into this, we can click any of these panels. So let's say I take source and I'm holding while I'm clicking. I'm just clicking and holding. And I can drag it to wherever I want to. I can put it in any of these other panels. So if I come over here to the program monitor and I go up to the top and highlight program monitor and I let go, it'll actually drag and drop source from over here to over here. So now I have the source monitor in this same panel as the program monitor. And you can click back and forth between those two if you want to. And that's one way that you can move things around. So if I wanted to drop it down here in the bottom in the timeline, click and drag, and that's probably a terrible place for it. So I'm gonna click and drag and put it back up here into this one. Now, when I put it back into this one, you see I have four panels up here. I can click in between each one of these, or I could shuffle them around however I want to. So you can move them around. I've just opened up the metadata panel, and this is one that I don't ever use. So if I wanted to close this, if I click on this menu, just go to close panel, and it'll get rid of that. And while we're closing a few things, I'm gonna close some other stuff. So I'm gonna come back down here to the project panel. I'm gonna click on media browser. I don't ever use this, so I'm gonna close that. Libraries, close that. Info, close that. Effects, I use that all the time, so I'm gonna leave that one open. Markers, close that. History, close that. So now this is pretty basic, pretty minimal. This is the way I like it. I like it as minimal as possible for what I'm trying to do. Another thing that I prefer is that my timeline take up the entire span of the bottom, so I really have a lot of space to work down there. So I wanna get all this other stuff out of that situation. So again, we can click and hold on a project, and I'm gonna come up here. And now instead of dragging it and dropping it into this same panel, I'm gonna come over here to the left, and I'm gonna drop it into this quadrant, and what that's gonna do when I let go is make it its own panel. So now the project panel lives on its own next to the source panel, and then next to the program monitor. So again, take effects and drag and drop that up here as well, just to get it out of the bottom. So now you can see at the bottom I have tools, which I'm gonna leave there. I have this entire space for my timeline. And then if I come over here to my audio meters, I can click into this line and drag it over a little bit. So now that's a little smaller. And I'm gonna leave that there just because it doesn't take up very much space. So this is how I like my bottom panel to be. You can make it however you want to, but I really like having this real estate to do whatever I want down there. Let's come back up to the top and let's start organizing this panel now. The project panel here, I want to have that first above anything else. So I'm going to drag it in front of effects. So now I have my project panel and then my effects panel, which that's fine. I'll leave that the way it is. So let's go on over here to the source monitor. Now in the source monitor, whenever I'm editing, especially since I haven't started anything in this project, what I'm going to do is have my source panel be by itself. So I want to have source here, and then I want to have program monitor over here. So one thing for me is have an audio clip mixer. That might be something that you want to keep around, but you don't necessarily want it in the beginning stages here. So instead of closing it, I just want to bring it off somewhere else. Now, one thing about the way I'm recording right now is that I actually have a second monitor. So if you look at my arrow here, I'm going to go to the left, and it's totally gone. It's on my second monitor. I don't have my capture set up so that you can see what happens as I go off the screen, but I will show you this. If I take audio clip mixer and I drag it off the screen, you can see it has a new window now. So if I let that go and I drag it back in so you can see what's happening, it actually brings it into its own window here. So if I take this and completely go off screen, now that window is living on my second monitor by itself, which is pretty nice to have that. You can have that feature and you can put all kinds of stuff in this and just drag it off to the side and then not have it taking up your workspace here, but still available to use whenever you want to. So I'm gonna bring that back in and I'm just gonna close it because I don't need that right now. So I'm gonna close that out. This is pretty similar to the way my actual workspace really is. So if I click on Joe C, if I was to click that, I think if I do click it, it's pretty much the same thing. I have project, effects, source, effects controls, program, timeline at the bottom, tools on the side, and my meters are at the top here. And say I wanted to bring that back down. If I just click at the top there and drag down, now I could put it to the left of this, or I could go into this green space and let that take up, let me close it down some, and let that take up the entire side here, which is pretty obnoxious and completely useless. So I'm gonna get that out of there. drag it back up here to the top, and again, smash it down because it's taking up too much real estate. So now, this right here is actually the setup. So we have project, effects, and then source, effects controls, program up here. This setup is actually the setup I use the most. This is where I like to be. I'm gonna go ahead and go back to editing. And now we're back to what you guys are looking at. Let's say you have a panel that you know you want, like for instance, Lumetri Color is something I use all the time whenever I'm coloring. Let's say I wanna have that panel up and I don't see it anywhere that I can click. So if we go up to Window and we come down here, we have all these different options of things that you can use to, you know, edit your footage. And so we have audio clip mixer, audio track mixer. I mean, you could read these and see what they are. You could click on them and they'll pop up in your workspace so you can look and see what they actually do. And all the ones that have check marks are all the active ones. So let's go ahead and click on Lumetri Color. We're gonna make that active. And it went ahead and just popped up over here. That might be perfect for what you're looking for. Maybe we wanna move it somewhere else. Again, I lost space down here in my timeline, so let's get that back. I'm gonna click and drag and just put it on the side, on the right-hand side here of the program monitor. Now it's up at the top, got my whole timeline space back. And so this is how you can go about changing the entire look and feel of this thing and really honing it down to what you want and what's useful for you. So let's say that this doesn't work over here. If we wanted to get it in the middle of these two, I would just put it here and let go. Couple of different ways you can do things is if I click and drag, I can drop it into this square, which again is gonna do the same thing if I let it go here. These will do the exact same thing. So let's test that out, and it did. If I come down, I go on the bottom, it'll actually split source and Lumetri Color. It'll split this entire panel in half. So you'll see source monitors up here at the top, Lumetri's down at the bottom. If I come back in there and put it up here, it'll just drop it at the top, still splitting it. Again, if you want it inside the same panel, you could drop it in this blue area here or down here at the bottom. The only other spaces that really show up whenever you're trying to do your workspace, again, are these green bars on the sides. And you could drop it over here on the left. Again, it's gonna take up the entire real estate over here on the left if I let it go, which it did. Or if I come over here to the right, it'll drop it on this side. Now you can see that I've completely made this thing super crazy, and I can sit there and adjust all this stuff back to the way that I wanna see it. Or I can go up to Window, go to Workspaces, and just go Reset to Saved Layout. And what that's gonna do is put it back to the way it originally was when I last saved it. And since I made all those edits and didn't save, it went ahead and brought it back to its original Premiere custom layout that Premiere decided was what it should be at default. I'm gonna go ahead and quickly do all the same things I did to get back to where you guys are. So come in here, close this, metadata, close that, media browser, close that, library, close that. Okay, so now I should roughly be back to about the same space that you guys were. And let's say that this is the optimal spot. This is what I love. I made this. I love the way this layout works. How can I make this a Joe C? How can I make this a custom workspace? So if you come up here to Window, we go to Workspaces, we can do a couple of things. We can do Save Changes to this workspace, which I'm not going to click because if I click that, it's going to change the editing default. So editing every time from then on will always look like this, the way we've just made it. The other option we can do if we go back to Window, Workspaces, is save as a new workplace. So, I'm sorry, workspace. So if we click that, type in custom, hit enter, and boom. Now you can see it dropped up here at the top and saying that's our custom workspace. So if I go back to editing, that's the way we already made it. And again, I can change this back to the way the defaults of going Window, Workspaces, Reset to Save Layout. And that brings it back to the way Premiere has set it up by default. And I can go back to my custom, and when I go to my custom, that's the way that we created it. So you can see how, you know, easy that is, especially since they already have a color preset. So if you're ever color correcting, you can just pop that open, and by default, they say this is the best way to do that. That's up for your opinion. Effects, if you wanted to put effects on it, you click on that one, and this is the best way to do effects, apparently. If you wanted to do some graphic work, that one actually is pretty decent. I would probably leave that one how it is. Audio work, et cetera, et cetera. You can click through all that stuff and figure it out for yourself. So you can see by clicking these, you can go between different workspaces. So I'm gonna go back to the custom one that we just made. So we're kind of back on the same page or whatever. And so yeah, I think that's pretty much it of how you make a custom workspace. I might've gone through that a little quick and sorry if I did, but it's pretty simple. I mean, you just click and drag. And when you start moving these around, you might be intimidated at first, like, oh, I might mess things up. And just keep in mind, if you just start clicking and dragging all over the place and really making things all wonky, and you're like, ah, oh, I've ruined everything. I don't even know how to set this back. How do I fix what I've just done here? You just go to Window, Make sure you're up at the top of this thing. Go to Workspace and then reset to save layout. And once you click that, it's going to go back to the last way that you've saved it. So that's an easy way to reset. I wouldn't recommend going into, say, color and then changing a bunch of stuff and then going to Window, Workspaces, and save changes to this workspace. I would not recommend doing that. I like to keep the defaults as the defaults. I always save as a new workspace. And when you do that, you can save as many as you want to. There's no limit to this. The only other thing I want to show you real quick before I end this tutorial is if you come over here, you see there's a down arrow. So if you don't have all of these options showing up, you can go down and there's even more stuff to be seen down there. And you can, again, go through that on your own time and see what else there is. All right, guys, so that's how you make a custom workspace in Adobe Premiere Pro. Soon I'll be uploading some more tutorials on Adobe Premiere Pro, Adobe After Effects, and Adobe Photoshop. So be on the lookout for those because they are coming soon. So until I see you guys next time, don't forget.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.